You all know that I am a palette fanatic. I love palettes to death. But there are times when I get palettes that are just no good. There's times when I order them in the mail and it's more of a process to send them back than it is to just keep them and then show you guys maybe what I didn't like. And then there's ones that I try and I initially think I'm gonna like and I end up not liking them. And then there are ones that I got on my perk points at Ulta. Have you done this before? And you take it back and you don't get the same amount of points, so I might as well just hold on to the darn things. Hi YouTube family, welcome into this palettes I regret purchasing in 2019. And I will give you a heads up that there is one palette in here that I purchased towards the end of 2018, but I just wanted to go ahead and show it to you guys. So we're gonna get right into this. You wanna see? That's all of them. I almost dropped them because it's so heavy. So we're gonna get into this right now. Please give this video a thumbs up if you wouldn't mind. And yeah, let's get into these palettes that definitely missed the mark for Mrs. Melissa. All right, I'm gonna start with ones that I just barely got. And I just barely showed these to you guys in my 21 eyeshadow palettes that I got during Black Friday. Now, I don't feel so bad about these because honestly, these were like, they were like $5 each. So I don't feel terrible about it. $5 is still enough for me to not like that I bought this many, but this is the Copycat Beauty palettes. And these are the ones that dupe Anastasia Beverly Hills. And then these are the ones that dupe the Huda Beauty ones. And I really thought that I was going to enjoy these, but there is hardly any pigmentation in them. They're very hard for me to build up. And I have just been really disappointed every time that I've reached for them. And I really did want to put them to the test because I do have two or three of these in my collection that are the actual ones. And I wanted to see if they were going to dupe well for the other ones, but they really didn't. So personally, I'm going to steer clear of Copycat Beauty's palettes that are dupes. They just were not that great. And then this is three palettes that I bought this year from Makeup Revolution. This is the new neutrals, which is supposed to be the dupe for the Huda Beauty palette. This dupe from Makeup Revolution was super powdery and super dry, and there was no pigmentation there. And even though the colors were close in match, they did not even build up. They just were not, it just did not turn out like I thought it would. And then I've actually also showed this one very recently in, I think this was monthly products. And this is their Cannabis Chilled palette. And I like the colors, but again, no pigmentation. This one I just showed you as well. This is called their Precious Stone Diamond palette. And it looks beautiful. It really does look beautiful. But again, no pigmentation out of these. And I said this very recently. I don't know what's happened to Makeup Revolution because way back when they started to bring out their palettes, when I was brand new into YouTube, I was loving it because I could buy a palette for under $15 and feel like I had something that I could use forever and just loved it. But they have changed something about their formula and I'm finding that I really just don't appreciate them anymore. And remember that I said that there was one at the end of 2019, it's from Colored Rain. And this isn't that this is a bad formula. As a matter of fact, when I've used this, I have liked it. This is just one that I don't reach for. This is an all matte palette with super vibrant colors. And I thought, oh my goodness, I'm going to get a ton of use out of that. Because you guys know I love my color and I love to use it. But you guys, I think I've only reached for this two times in the year and some days that I have had it. And I love the purples down here, but all the other colors, even the blues, I'm not that crazy about. Now, don't get me wrong, you guys, because honestly, check it out. Those are very, very vibrant colors and they're very pigmented. They're easy to blend. I stick my finger in there. I don't feel like they're chalky or hard. They do have a little bit of kick up, but that's something that we've all come to get used to, even with Anastasia Beverly Hills palettes. But I just have not reached for this one. And I'm sorry that I bought it simply because it cost me to get each individual one and then you put it into the palette. So it was kind of pricey. You guys, you know how expensive singles can be. They do have this as just a palette now. And if you are one that absolutely adores colors and you love using the matte ones, then go for it. But for me, this one is a regret because I honestly never ever reach for it. I guess maybe it's just that those are too stark or something as I'm, you know, working with them. I'm not sure. The next one you guys are gonna be shocked about because I usually love absolutely everything from Juvia's Place. This is not about their formula. This is not about anything except for the color scheme. This is their Tribe palette. This is a beautiful palette, but I'll tell you right now that the only colors that I have ever even reached into are this one right here, which has a little green tint to it, and then this teal right here, which is so pretty. Sorry, that got all over and I had to get the swatches again. So I'll just show you four of them right there. They're very beautiful, they're very blendable, but the colors just aren't for me. I'm very cool toned and I'm not able to wear neon colors, and this whole row right here is neon colors. The orange is pretty neon in itself. I don't wear oranges just because of my tone. So this row right here is really the only thing that I've gotten any use of whatsoever. And I've barely opened this again. It's the same thing as the Colored Rain palette. Even though I like it, I think it's pretty, it just wasn't for me and I regret purchasing it. Okay, the next few might come as a little bit of a shock to you guys because they're actually a shock for me. But these are the Huda Beauty Little Obsession palettes. And this one is Amethyst, Sapphire, Emerald, and Ruby. I do like the Amethyst one, but you guys, at the same time, I don't feel like this is full of purples, amethyst colors. I feel like it's more along the lines of pinks. And so I was quite disappointed in that. I do like this color right here. It's a really pretty iridescent color. So I do like that. But one color out of nine, that just doesn't grab me. So I was kind of disappointed in that. This is the blue ones. They threw a yellow in there and I don't feel like there are any really great blues in here. Again, disappointed in that, and I'm actually quite disappointed in these formulas too, because I feel like for the price, I think these were $27 each. I did get them on sale, but still, it's one of those things where you look at them and you go, why didn't I just not buy the bundle and buy a single one and see how I felt about it? This green one actually is probably the only one that I feel like I can look at it, dip into it, and do an entire look, because it does have a little bit of diversity in there. But then the ruby one, same thing. I just feel like it's not one that I can just go with and completely complete a look at. So those are a huge disappointment to me. And the formula is a little bit disappointing as well, because each individual shadow can either have really great pigment or not at all. And they will have a lot of fallout, especially those more chunky metallics. They did have quite a bit of fallout, so I wasn't real happy with that either. You make a mess on your makeup, blah, blah, blah. So yeah, that was another one that I was a little bit disappointed in. And then the Carly Bible palette, I think I've reached for this twice since I got it. And every time I go ahead and I reach for another palette besides this one to finish my look, I just feel like there are so many toppers in here that you would use just to go over top of other colors that it really didn't make sense to me. This little purple down here that I thought would be such a great color for putting across the lid, it's just a very transparent wash of color. And there's several others in here. I have tried using some of these. Some of them are almost too soft to use. I just felt like as I opened it, I was completely uninspired each time I opened it and I tried to use it. So that is just my thought on that. Also, you guys know how much I love Dominique Cosmetics and I love all of her palettes. I actually do own all of her palettes except for her Sweater Weather one. I don't own that one, but this is the Celestial Storm one. I thought I was gonna absolutely die in love with this one, you guys, but the colors are too stark for me. And then the colors that I thought I could use and get a lot of use out of were colors that were, again, topper colors. I know why creators are putting topper colors into their palettes, but at the same time, I personally am not a fan of them. There are some beautiful colors in here, but all of these right here, they're like way too stark or orange for me right here. And then down here, these are the colors that I've tried to use and they just haven't worked out for me. And then this color right here is a beautiful chocolate color and I do like it. But one out of how many, 12, is just not good enough for me to say, oh, I'm so glad I put my money out on this. And it, for me, as they were doing looks with them, I was so excited about this one because I thought I would get a ton of use out of it because of its color story. But I'm just finding again that I've only reached for it twice and have not been happy with the looks that I got out of it. Okay, last one. This one is the one that I was just saying that at Ulta I used all my points to get. Well, it's not, you know, all my points, but I used a lot of points to get this. And this is the ABH Norvina. Now, this palette is got a lot of purples in it, but I thought it was going to be more along the lines of really true purples. Like when I saw it on the website, I thought that these colors right through here were all going to be kind of purpley colors. It ends up just being like one, two really true purple colors, a couple of violet colors, and then the whole rest of it is not really anything to do with the colors that would lend towards violet. I got sucked into the hype on this one instead of doing my research on it, and I really should have. And it taught me a good lesson because I know that there are palettes that are out there at the drugstore that are every bit as good, and you can get the colors that you actually want. But it had taught me by the time I was done with this one that I better be more careful. So you guys, those are the palettes that really disappointed me in 2019. I hope that you like this video. If they're palettes that you use and you love, please take this with a grain of salt. I think that that is why we have so much makeup on the market, so many palettes on the market, and so much to choose from, is because we're diverse. We're all so different, and we all love such different things, but these are the ones that just didn't work out for me for one reason or another. Thank you so much for watching with me today. I hope that everybody is happy and healthy. Please give this video a thumbs up on your way out of here. It really does help me out a lot. Oh, and don't forget to ring your notification bell to be notified of any future videos I'm going to be putting up, because a lot of people have said that it is working, it's not working, so they have to go in and do it again. So just kind of a heads up on that. Everyone take care of yourselves. Love you very much. Catch you all in my next video. Bye, guys.